Our overwhelming exploitation of resources, propelled by a rapidly expanding population, has the Earth hurtling towards an existential crisis. This increasing population growth places a strain on our social and economic infrastructure, leading to greater societal distrust. Moreover, the massive burning of coal by the same burgeoning population further poisons our planet with toxic smoke. It has become increasingly clear that we are in urgent need of a second home, as our willingness to save this one appears lacking. Mars has long appeared to be an appealing choice, strongly favored by figures like Elon Musk, whose vision extends beyond exploration to terraforming. Though enticing, a journey to Mars comes with formidable challenges. Given its distance from Earth, a trip to Mars takes months or longer, depending on its planetary alignment with Earth. Communication delays extend up to 4 minutes, and such delays could prove fatal in times of unprecedented emergencies. Furthermore, the logistics of sending large amounts of infrastructure to establish colonies on Mars are presently insurmountable due to the necessity of larger, fuel-consuming rockets. A more accessible celestial body for colonization might be our nightly companion, the Moon, requiring only 3 days of travel and mere seconds in communication delay. Its proximity would allow for more effective handling of emergencies, and the transportation of necessary infrastructure would be significantly less cumbersome than deliveries to Mars. Despite these advantages, scientists remain more inclined towards Mars for colonization. The Apollo missions of the 1960s and 70s brought back around 840 piles of moon rock and soil, revealing geological similarities to Earth. This indicated that the Moon may have formed from a fragment of Earth following a tremendous cosmic impact. Mars, however, has a composition distinct from both Earth and the Moon. Mars possesses a protective atmosphere, like Earth, though it does not contain breathable pressurized oxygen. This atmosphere safeguards Mars and any potential settlers from dangerous meteoroid rains and harmful UV sun rays, which are obvious threats on the Moon due to its lack of an atmosphere. Moreover, temperature fluctuations are extreme on the Moon, varying from a roasting 253 degrees Fahrenheit to a freezing negative 387 degrees Fahrenheit every day. The Moon's weak gravity holds no atmosphere or gases, unlike Mars, which does have an atmospheric shield, and a gravitational force 3 times stronger than the Moon's. Moon settlers would require a long adaptation period to such weak gravity, while the Mars environment would be somewhat familiar at only 1/3 the force of Earth's gravity. Furthermore, a fine, abrasive dust known as regolith coats the Moon's surface, posing a danger to machinery and human lives. Nonetheless, beneath its inhospitable exterior, the Moon may contain hidden wonders. Missions by the Lunar Prospector and the Clementine probe suggested potential reserves of water amassed beneath layers of dust and ice. This water supply could aid human sanitation, food production, and even the production of breathable oxygen. Advocates also suggest that the destructive regolith might serve as a radiation shield or provide oxygen itself. The Moon's poles could be ideal for habitation, with their consistent temperatures and possible ice reserves, despite the sharp and uneven terrain, which would pose a considerable challenge to landing and construction. However, any potential benefits of Moon colonization must wrestle with the lingering doubts about its oppressing and uninhabitable conditions. When taking into account the practicality and relative costs of travel for colonization, the Moon, in the short term, seems economically viable. However, in the grand scale of possibilities and sustainability, Mars triumphs as the wiser choice for long-term human habitation. As the debate continues, one thing is clear: the need for an alternative home for mankind is more pressing than ever before.